Welcome back to Weekend's Mass. This tourney is a little bit special. This tournament is an Amiibo tourney. That's right. No CPUs in this one. Just all out Amiibo action. We have Mario the Dr. Mario Amiibo. Fire Luigi, the Luigi Amiibo. Paxter, the Pac-Man Amiibo. Less Man, the Mega Man Amiibo. Sakurai, the Kirby Amiibo. Yoshi, the Yoshi Amiibo. Super Kong, the Donkey Kong Amiibo. And last not least, the Blur, the Sonic the Hedgehog Amiibo. I'm going to do some shuffling, and then when I stop, things will be held as they are. Alright, here I am. I'm shuffling. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, stop! Alright, first match are two choppers. And the next match is, you know, go ahead, I was doing so good too. Okay, the first match have choppers, next one is Luigi and Westman, next one is Mario Sonic, I'm passing by the way, and the last one is Yoshi and Donkey Kong. Right? Yoshi and Donkey Kong are two characters that don't speak, but yet, people are able to translate what they apparently say. So yeah, this is going to work out. Alright, I'm done talking, let's go! Before I let the tournament begin, I must ask, how you doing? I hope life is treating you well. I'm looking forward to this. All out Amiibo action. All these Amiibos are about to get some experience. Alright, first match, Sakurai versus Paxter. We have two characters that are known for eating things and never stopping. They never get full. So, which chopper is the better chopper? The only one way to find out. Alright, usually I would take things for granted opening, but I do have a new stage called Smash Coliseum. I was thinking about the King of Fighters stage, and I was trying to create my own version of a stage that has, like, walls get touched. But things didn't work out. Instead, I ended up making a big stage that has a battlefield over the battleground. So, this tournament is going to be switching places. Instead of the grass opening, we're going to head to this Smash Coliseum. Alright, Sakurai versus Paxter. Who will win? Right, here we go. And whenever battles begin, the characters will always be on the floating platform. Or the floating battlefield. And as you can see, all the sand, says the sand in the background, all the sand is in the form of a battlefield because, you know, there's a big coliseum. And then when the fighters decide to go to the bottom, they'll see that there's an actual floor waiting for them. So this is going to be quite the stage. Yeah, it's a big one. So this stage is a big one, so they got to make their smash attacks count. Or things, you know, could take forever. But so far, these two fighters are going all out. Like, yeah, the Coliseum is big, but it's not stopping them from just going at it nonstop. Thinking about this stage. Oh, there you go. And there's the ground. They finally hopped off the floating battlefield, and now they're fighting on the actual ground. What do you think of this stage? I hope this stage is nice. I know it's a nice stage because I made it. And who would be proud of their own creation? Well, when creation ends up having mistakes, then yeah, you won't be as happy. But other than that, usually when you're the creator, you can't help but just be happy. So, I would say I'm proud of this stage, because this stage came from one idea, and then it became another idea. The first idea was having my own walls that prevent fighters from escaping. But there was a flaw. Apparently, the characters were able to get knocked off above the wall I made, and then when they try to return, they hit the back of the wall, making them explode automatically immediately. But yeah, that was a flaw in what my first idea was going for. So I just decided I want to make a big Colosseum and have a floating battlefield right over the ground. And I think that was a much better idea on my part. So now they'll take the battle down low on the ground. And whenever they feel like heading up, there will always be a battlefield waiting for them. And Kirby sliced the trampoline into the Pac-Man. So, ain't that something? Oh, that's my son's about to put an end to Baxter. Alright, a neutral attack. Not bad, not bad. You can go along with a neutral fail attack. It comes a lot. And there goes Baxter. Alright, this match is pretty even so far. And you know what? With this last Coliseum, I might as well let this stage be the new tournament stage. Like, maybe that's your opening for a tournament stage, but honestly, I think I prefer the Smash Coliseum now, because it's a Coliseum. An era where you just enter, and then there's just nothing but a huge circle, and then there's full of a crowd. So yeah, the tournaments are going to take place in the Smash Coliseum from now on, because it is a Smash Coliseum. Smash is in the name. And as for graduate opening, well, I still do like that stage, so I'm not going to necessarily get rid of it. It will stay, but it will no longer be the tournament stage. Yes. It is confirmed that the Smash Coliseum is the new tournament stage for Weekend Smash. Ooh. Alright, so far this battle is pretty nice. Kirby's taking a lot of damage, a good hit will do him in, even on a big stage like this one. And Patcher gets knocked out by another neutral air attack. And Patcher's going all out, but we're able to... Alright, he managed to chuck Sakurai, and Sakurai went flying. Now, will Kirby be able to catch up to Patcher and take this match to sudden death? Well, we're going to find out. We're going to keep watching. Oh, that was a nice hammer attack from Sakurai. And Pastor was too slow to react, so he ended up hanging on the edge and got sliced. Alright, so 25 seconds left, and seeing how big this Coliseum is, this match is guaranteed to go to sudden death. But will there be a match where someone actually manages to take a win without sudden death? With those Smash Attacks Patcher's using, he might be able to get another knockout. But let's see. No, probably not. Time to play out. Sudden death it is. Here we go. Who will win? Wow! Did you see that? At the last second, Baxter was able to grab Kirby and just toss him toward the flames, as he was burning in the flames too. Way to go, Baxter! That was a great play! And Sakurai, you were a fantastic fighter! Kudos to both fighters in that battle, that was amazing! Right, next up we have Fire Luigi versus Rushman! Now what is Rushman? Well, Rushman is supposed to be a reference to Mega Man powered up with Rush. I saw the source on YouTube, and YouTube is the only reason why me, of all people, will know anything about the old Mega Man games. Alright, Luigi versus Rushman. Let's see which fighter will make it to the finals. Oh, by the way, the rules are still set up to what I've had before. The final fighters will have a free-for-all for the trophy, because I feel like that makes things interesting. Like, we start things off with one-on-ones, and then it all leads up to one big free-for-all. I think I like that. So, that rule will not change. Right, so far, Luigi's just hopping about all over the place. Yes, he is Mario's brother, so that makes him a Jumpman too, but it's nice to stand on the ground once in a while, just wait for someone to make a mistake, so you can go in for a really good hit. That's a Rushman, well, he's doing exactly what he's known to do, hopping and shooting pellets. Ooh, and that's not something to do him in. Right, nice toss. Another nice toss of that neutral projectile of his. Ooh, and that was a nice up smash from Fire Luigi. He saw an opening and he just took it. Ooh, nice combo there. A soft neutral air attack to an up smash. Not bad at all. Uh-oh, it looks like Rushman's stats have boosted. Rushman is set to have his attack, defense, and speed increase whenever he takes critical damage. Because I feel like that's fitting for a character like Mega Man. And as for Fire Luigi, well, because he's Fire Luigi, I decided to buff up all his special moves to have fire. So the Fireball, the Green Missile, and the Super Jump Punch, because the Luigi Super Jump Punch has fire. Now for the Down Special, well, there's no fire on that, so that move doesn't get a buff. But all of Luigi's, most of Luigi's special moves have been increased thanks to the skills I gave him. Like the Up B, by the way, Final Smash, oh no. And wow, if that was in your face, that would have done him in. But this Godzilla was a big one, so you gotta be really creative if you want to just go off before you go all out. And I'm saying, Luigi's Up Special, Side Special, and Neutral Special are buffed up thanks to the spirits because they have fire. And as Fire Luigi, Luigi should have more power in his fire. Again, that was the other stage, but he would have been done for it. But I think this one's gonna get Rushman for sure. Yep, Rushman is out of there. What's Rushman gonna do? He's gonna do something. You gotta think of the truth, Rushman. Fire Luigi's got the lead. Right, more pellets. Nothing wrong with adding more damage. But eventually he's got to hit big if he wants to keep up. Alright, 2 minutes are remaining in this battle. And I do believe that's about that one just may probably be buff. Yeah. After this, I'm gonna make some changes to the three little platforms above the, battlefield. Yeah, the biggest sand. Yeah, that can remain as it is, but I'm gonna change the three platforms. Alright. By the way, he's at 164, and he is still in this thing. Based how big the stage is, characters are a lot more safe. On a much smaller stage, you would have been pushing a long time ago, but on a stage like this, you got to really work for it. You gotta really work for a knockout. I think I'll make things more interesting. Alright, due to how big the stage is, you don't have to worry about characters making mistakes if they're falling off the stage. Because things like that can make a good match end so quickly, and that wouldn't be as entertaining, And there it is! Rushman fires on opening and took it! Now both fighters have 2 stocks! Right now, less than a minute left, and they just now lost 1 stock. Wow, nice catch from Fire Luigi. Alright, nice neutral attack, okay. Another neutral air attack, okay. A back air attack, nice, nice. Oh, and that up special made them go right into that final smash. Alright, 3 damage for us, man. Alright, can Fire Luigi get one more knockout, or will this be another sudden death? Here we go. Sudden death it is. Who will win? It's 3-1's game now. Luigi's about to get away from the flames. Well, Fire's about to get away from the flames. Wow! Wow! Now that was cool! Rushman summoned Rush, although he's supposed to be powered up with Rush. Yeah. Rushman used Rush, and Luigi chased him and knocked him out with his neutral air attack. That was something else! Fight! Great fight! Great fight! Next up, we have Mario and a Blur. Or Sonic, if you want to just call Sonic Sonic. I understand that it's a lot easier, so if you want that, then we'll go with that. Alright, back to Smash Coliseum. We have a classic rivalry here. Like, Mario was born first.
Yeah.
Mario was born first, and then Sonic came in to be the new character of Adventure. But Sonic added something new to the table. Instead of taking a time, he was all about the speed. And it was very interesting to go on an adventure with high top speed. And now since then, Mario and Sonic have both been very big due to their adventures. Nowadays, they work together in the Olympic Games, and that's pretty cool. Alright, the Blur is a crazy one here. He has Impact Run and Insta Drop. Because he likes to run fast to the point where it knocks everything away, and he has this ability to just stomp fast. So that's what the Blur's working out with. He has Insta Drop and Impact Run. And after Dr. Mario, well, I love Dr. Mario, so I tried to give him better jumping and faster movement. Because Dr. Mario is slower than the original Mario. But, although Dr. Mario is not as fast as Mario, he hits harder. So, I still like Dr. Mario more. I like Dr. Mario more because he carries the tornado move Mario had back in the Nintendo 64 days. He may not have the downward twirl, but at least his new stopping move gives him an opportunity to just spike people. So, I think it's nice that Dr. Mario now has a spike move. Right, both of these fighters have high damage, and seem to look pretty good. And by that, I mean, this fight's interesting. Look at these fighters go! They're fighting really hard, and they can't seem to find a good opening! And these fighters are everywhere! But Sonic kinda has up a hand because with the Insta Drop, he is even more fast than usual. Oh! That up match should have done a trick! It looks like Sonic's ready to go! And Mario barely made it. Well, he didn't make it, but he was close. He almost survived, but he ran out of luck at the last second. And an up smash tells Sonic that pretty much Mario sent back at you. Sonic took a stop, and Mario took a stop off of Sonic. Yeah, that's what I was trying to say. Pardon me for the awkward commentary. Although I've been doing YouTube for a while now, I still have what to do with my commentary, because the front of my commentary is always a little bit on the awkward side. But I can't really do much about it, because the best way to enjoy being a YouTube person is just be yourself, you know? So I don't want to improve my commentary, I don't want to change myself in the process of changing my commentary. Otherwise, it wouldn't be me. And not being me wouldn't make things entertaining. But Mario's kicking with the final smash! He's gonna make this one count, since it's a big coliseum. So I say wait until you go to the far left or far right. Right, that's a good spot. Mario's gonna do it now. And Sonic was actually waiting. A Pager Amiibo is a scary Amiibo. Because Amiibos are pretty much CPUs, but like, when it's a CPU not moving, it's scary. Because CPUs are known for being so sporadic. Yeah, CPUs are known for being very wild, they never hold still. So when you say CPU just staying one spot, like a player, it's intimidating because it just shows how smart they really are. And that was a really good up smash, but it won't be enough to knock out Mario in this big coliseum. Another solid up smash. Again, it won't do due to the coliseum being extra big. Oh, nice parry from Mario. Wait, a good smash attack on a battlefield would be enough to knock out Mario. But will Sonic be able to, you know, knock out Mario, or Mario find a way to outrun Sonic? Come on, character. And Mario loses another star. He has 17 seconds to make a comeback. Can Mario take a stock off of Sonic? Or will Sonic take the victory? What are you gonna do, Mario? You gotta think fast! You ain't gonna die! Come on! Mario! You gotta do something! No Sonic death here. Sorry, Mario. Mario could have done something, but Sonic was just too fast. Alright, moving on to the last battle for the first round. We have Yoshin versus Super Kong. Now Yoshin has a lot of really good amiibo. Every time I see Yoshin in action, Yoshin does like so much. And as a Super Kong, well, Super Kong's new here, so I have to see what he's capable of. Alright, let's see what these amiibos can do. Woo! Uh-oh. Alright, so far, both fighters are just trying to study one another. Super Kong dodges a lot, I've noticed that. Now Yoshin's trying to get Super Kong, but Super Kong is just non-stop with the dodging maneuver, and he's doing a fantastic job at dodging. Oh, shoot. Yoshin's going all out, bringing Super Kong to the very end of the ground. Alright, next blast attack from Super Kong. Again, Super Kong is doing lots of dodging. He's doing his best to stay out of danger. I mean, it's a good evasion is very important, but at the same time, you gotta put on some offense once in a while. Otherwise, the evasion will become predictable. Nice! Alright, Super Kong is cooking. He's ready to go with the final smash. But will he be able to catch Yoshin? So close. Oh, Super Kong had the right timing, but he was just out of reach. The good thing about Super Kong is that as a big character, he can kind of take more. So this is a worry about now, like, Super Kong is a big character, but even he can get knocked out if he takes too much damage. And with that, Yoshin is now in the lead. What's Super Kong gonna do? I mean, as a big Kong, he'll take action more, but he's very cautious. I might have to change Super Kong's style. Super Kong is a cautious amiibo. I want a character like Donkey Kong to be more than a cautious amiibo. Yeah, so I'm just gonna do some tweaking with Super Kong. Like, Super Kong is a big character, so I don't want him to be too cautious. But he should use his size to his advantage. Alright, nice down smash. Just a little more. Okay. Super Kong is cooking something up. Oh no. Woohoo! Oh no! Alright, Super Kong has another final smash. Will he be able to make this one count? Alright, Super Kong, whenever you're ready, go for it! Alright, a nice up smash to the trick. And now both fighters are even with two stops. And there goes the final smash with the Super Kong go! Booyah! Good damage. Alright. Yeah. My both finals are still in this thing, but Yoshin has been racking up a lot of damage. Whoa, that was close! Well, a good smash attack will knock out Super Kong, but will Yoshin be able to get a Super Smash in? Super Smash. Smash attack in? What's Yoshin gonna do? Super Kong is almost like 200%. Must be sudden death right now. Oh shoot! Alright, time's running out. Sudden death, what's gonna happen? No way! After all that? I guess patience was the key to victory for Super Kong here. Alright, Yoshin, you did very well! Alright, it's time for the finals! We have the four fighters that's gonna go all out in a free-for-all. And the four fighters are Paxter, Fire Luigi, The Blur, and Super Kong. Now, although Smash Bros. Seems a big one, the rule still stands that whenever the finals is up, it's time to head toward Final Destination. But is Final Destination have platforms or no? Platforms? No platforms. No platforms. No platforms. It's suspended by solid ground and willpower. Alright. The last four battles are here. Who's going to be the champion of this tournament? Alright, things are going to get crazy now. Alright, so far, Paxter hasn't been touched. He's doing a good job of staying out of danger. Uh-oh, and now Paxter is getting a little damaged. Alright, Sonic seems to go all out with those smash attacks. Ooh, nice smash attack from Sonic. Oh no, the trampoline just... Wait a minute. Will Luigi survive? How did he do that? He ran a trampoline, the trampoline was bad, so Luigi fell down, but somehow, someone managed to hit him, and then Luigi was able to recover. It was like he had a second jump in store. I thought he used it up already. That was amazing. Like, it had to be a second jump, because Luigi can't wall jump. So Luigi had another jump in store, and I can't believe it. That was incredible. Right. The Blur is left behind with only two stocks. And now Luigi only has two stocks. Super Kong is ready. Oh, that final smash in store. And wow! Did you see that? That one punch connected with all the characters at one time. It was one at a time, but he got them all with that one punch. That was incredible. And now it's Paxter's turn to lock out. And it looks like Paxter had no luck there. Now it's Sonic's turn to lock out. Will Liam not feel it out? Yes, he will. Sonic has knocked out Luigi. And now Luigi and Sonic have one stop left. They need to be more careful than we're going to survive. Out of Super Kong and Paxter, they have two stops, so they can afford to be a little reckless, but not too reckless. Otherwise, and look at that. The trampoline messes up Super Kong. I can't believe it's a tricky thing. Yeah, I know it's a Pac-Man, but once it goes red, you might not want to touch it, or you'll be falling down faster you can blink. Oh! Oh! Wow, Pac-Man just did two footstools on Luigi, and Luigi still managed to survive. That was crazy. These battles looking nice! Pac-Man Fox doesn't leave with two spots. But does that mean he's not? That's him. Oh my god! And Sonic is out of for good. I guess being a fast single high means he was the fastest to go. Goodbye to Bacall. It's up to Luigi and Pasta to keep things going. But who would be the winner of this Amiibo tournament? Alright, Luigi with a good up tilt. Luigi with a good side tilt. Or a front air attack. Alright, both fighters just hopping about, trying to steady one another. Looking for an opening, as they jump around. Ooh, Luigi went for a smash attack, but he misses. Oh, that was good back attack with a check. Luigi might not want to touch the trampoline again. Oh, Paxton's ready to go. This could be it. This could be the move. And Pastor has done it. Pastor is the Amiibo winner. Way to go, Pastor. Way to go. Oh, that was an awesome tournament. I don't have to do that again sometime. Congratulations to Pastor. That was a fantastic tournament. Tune in for more tournaments like these next year. If you enjoyed this video, please click the like button for me. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel if I want to see. Laughing Sam, I'm out of here. Later, viewers. Well done, Amiibos. Well done. I'm